Hey everyone, here with title contender Sulam Urbina, who takes on Marlene Esparza on Friday, October 30th. Big fight, WBC eliminator. First and foremost, how are you and how are you dealing with this COVID-19 situation?
Well, I'm doing well. Luckily, my family and I are healthy. You know, it's strange times living through COVID. It's a lot of ups and downs emotionally, I believe. But we're doing the best that we can and dealing with it and trying to get by.
Just from, you know, speaking with other fighters, you know, they're having trouble getting access to a boxing gym. You know, has it been difficult for you to get that access and also maybe get the proper sparring for someone, you know, to take on someone like in the Marlene Esparza?
Definitely. I think, you know, when we first started with this pandemic, we were training at a park. I was training at, you know, in Arizona, it's pretty hot. So it was like 120 degree weather at 5:30 p.m. out in the sun. But, you know, I stayed working out, stayed active, obviously not really fight ready because you don't have a lot of things that you need to get ready for a fight. But then slowly things in Arizona started opening up and I was able to start attending a boxing club that a friend of ours lets me train in. And, you know, a few weeks ago I started getting some sparring in. So that's good. And I think I'll be more than ready for October 30th. I know I will.
And now that this is, you know, like we mentioned, this is a WBC eliminator. You are ranked number 4. I think Marlene is down at 15. But, you know, she is a tough challenge. You know, we saw what she's done in her career, being, you know, winning a bronze medal in the Olympics. You know, what type of matchup are you expecting against Marlene?
You know, I'm expecting the best Marlene as far as possible after that loss. Sorry. What happened? I'm losing my voice.
No worries. We'll cut that. No worries.
Okay. after that loss that she had against Sunisa Estrada, I think that she's going to come more ready, more focused. She maybe realized that she wasn't a made boxer yet and that she had a lot to grow on. I think that, you know, she's going to come ready. I'm expecting her to, you know, be very aggressive, which I hope she is, and I hope she doesn't run, but we'll see what happens. I'm expecting her to be ready for Sulam Urbina because we know each other very well, and I believe we bring out the best in each other when we fight. And come October 30th, the fans are going to be extremely satisfied.
Yeah, that was my next question. You know, we've seen you guys online, I think, a couple of times before. You guys have, you know, exchanged pleasant comments. Are you friends with Marlene? Or is it more of a respect?
It was, you know, it's a weird relationship with her. You don't know what Marlene Esparza you're going to get. You know, one day you get the one that's very cool and nice to you, and then the next she goes trash-talking behind your back. So, I mean, last year we got into it on Fino Boxing. So that was it. It was over for me right there. I'm done. I can't say we're friends. We don't get along. I'm not planning on getting along with her anytime soon. You know, as a boxer, she's a great boxer. As a person, things are a little bit rocky right there.
Okay, so you feel you have a chip on your shoulder that you have to prove not only to her, but, you know, I guess you could say the doubters and the haters that you have enough, you know, to beat.
I have enough. I know that I've been evolving pretty well in the pros. You know, she did beat me in the amateurs, and I think it's something that she's very confident about. But, you know, the amateurs and the pros, they're two different sports. I believe she said that on Fino Boxing, she said, oh, this fight probably won't happen anytime soon. And guess what? It's happening right now. So come October 30th, the fans are going to be extremely satisfied, and I'm going to be satisfied when I win.
Definitely. I do remember making that post, obviously, about a possible matchup between you two. It's a fight that, you know, you guys are big names in the female boxing, in boxing in general, so it's a fight that makes sense. But, you know, now that it's actually here, you know, how long did it take for you to sign on the dotted line that this is the fight that you were willing to take?
They called my husband, and he called me. I said yes right away. And so within 5 minutes, I had already agreed. It took her some time to finally agree to it, but, you know, I needed to shut her up. I'm here to take the fight. And luckily she was willing to take the challenge also and give the fans a great fight. You know, through this pandemic, I believe that it's fights like these that people really want to see. And it's gonna, you know, be uplifting to them and enjoyable, and they're going to be happy about it. And like you said, we are two big names in boxing with women, and it's going to be a great fight.
Yeah, I mean, you see that interaction with fans, you know, every time we post about you or Marlene, you know, it's a matchup that now that it's official, it's actually generating a lot of interest, especially, you know, on a card like that. It is a stacked card on Friday, October 30th, headlined by Jaime Munguia against Toronto Johnson. You know, being part of Golden Boy, I know you fought in Golden Boy before. I know through Thirst Diaz, you know, and Robert Diaz said you are official part of Golden Boy. Mm-hmm. Can you clarify a little bit about that? Have you signed an official contract to join the Golden Boy ranks?
We haven't signed an official contract. They haven't. The offices have been closed here and there and open. But, I mean, I believe in Roberto Diaz. I believe in his word. He's a man of his word. So I have no doubt. And I feel like I'm part of Golden Boy. Everybody treats me like it. And they're very happy with me. You know, I fought on their first card back in November. Then they called me up again in February. And they loved my performances, and from there on, you know, they told me, that's it, you're staying, you're here with us. And, you know, at the end of the day, I get the next palabra, you know, and I believe in them.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you were one of those fighters who, you know, they rarely, just from what I know, highly regarded, and obviously being part of Golden Boy, those two fights, I know, right, you fought right before, you know, COVID came in on a massive, so you kind of have that experience where you actually have not been away from the ring that long. You know, finally, what message do you have to all the fight fans who have to tune in on Friday, October 30th and see this matchup again for you as far as?
Friday, October 30th, it's going to be a great night. Marlene and I bring out the best in each other, so expect fireworks. I hope she doesn't run. So Marlene Esparza, don't run, you know, come at me. And let's give the fans a great fight.
Do you feel, now that you mentioned, obviously, she is a great boxer, you know, she's, like you mentioned, she, you know, she, they've won a bronze medal at the Olympics. You know, you think you have to cut off the ring, you have to chase it down, you know, punch the body to make it a more of a, you know, a style to your type of fight?
You know, I think I do, because she's going to want to move. I know she's not going to want to bang with me. She doesn't have it. And so she's been working on it. I'm not sure if she will. I hope she tries to come and bang with me. It'll be fun for me. And I know I have the upper hand in that.
Do you see yourself ending up beating Esparza by knockout?
Definitely. I think I'm a very strong fighter. I have a really good pro style. I've developed very well, and I don't think she'll be ready to bang with me.
Definitely. Well, those are definitely fighting words. You know, we can't wait to see it take place. Now, with the victory, obviously, it's a WBC eliminator. I would imagine the next fight, it will be for a world title.
Definitely. The WBC world champ is Yvette Zamora. She used to help me when I was an amateur living in Mexico City, getting ready for the Pan Am Games. And I helped her while she was getting ready to defend her crown. And I think it's stylistically, it's a great matchup. And winning October 30th, that's what's next.
Yeah. You know, if I could just take a couple more questions. I don't know how busy your schedule is, but I just wanted to get your thoughts. You know, it's a lot of conversation, and especially going on boxing Twitter, that female fighters should fight three rounds. What's your take on that? Obviously, I think you guys deserve a higher pay as well, but do you feel that, you know, you're willing to eventually do 3-minute rounds?
I feel like I already trained for 3-minute rounds. You know, you can show up to a boxing gym, everything's set around 3 minutes. I believe that as a fighter, we always want to fight more. Now, there's people around us that are there to protect us. I'm not a scientist. I'm not a doctor. You know, men and women are different. You know, as a fighter, I do believe that I can go 3-minute rounds, and I would get more knockouts that way. If you saw my last fight, I hurt my opponent a few times, and then the bell would ring, and I hurt her again, and then the bell would ring, and I believe she took more punishment in the long run, you know, not going down. In the earlier rounds, but it is what it is. I'm going to be ready for 2 minutes. If they change it, I'll be ready for 3.
Definitely. That was a brutal war against Noemi Volsquez when you beat her at Fantasy. But like you said, you know, 3-minute rounds, hopefully, you know, if it makes sense, if the science backs it up, that you actually do the 3-minute rounds, I think fight fans would actually be happy with that. But I mean, right now, female boxing, you know, we've seen a rise in the sports. Obviously, you have, you know, the Cecilia Breakhus, who sadly lost against Jesse McCaskill. You have Clarissa Shields. You have Michaela Mayer. You have Sinisha Estrada, Marina Esparza. I mean, you could go on and on. How many great Katie Taylor, how many great female fighters are, you know, how much of a change have you seen in female boxing? And what do you tell those fans who actually might not like female fighting?
Well, ever since 2016, it's been a different era here in the United States. In other countries like Argentina, Mexico, you know, in China, in all of Europe, you know, they've supported women in boxing. They're always televised. USA is kind of, in a way, sort of playing catch up ever since, you know, Leila Ali, Christy Martin, it kind of, you know, slowed down a bit here in the U.S. And since 2016, the elite amateurs decided to turn pro, and it's picked up since then. And, you know, we have to thank the women that have come before us, and we have to keep doing a great job for the women that are coming after us. So for the people that don't support women in boxing, don't believe in us, or whatever the case may be, remember, you have a mother, you have daughters, you have nieces, you have women all around you. Don't ever tell them they can't do something.
Yeah, definitely. You know, the future is female, so you can count in. We do support female boxing here at Female Boxing. But do you think the media has maybe a little bit of blame, or maybe the promoters or the TV networks who haven't actually showcased? We've seen UFC, you know, make stars of their female fighters, mm-hmm. You know. Do you think it's a combination of blame, in a sense?
It's a combination of blame, you know, all the way around. I think there's a lot. Female boxing supports women in boxing. You know, there's other media outlets that don't even post about us. There's some reporters that never do their homework about us that, you know, you can tell they're just doing an interview because they're getting paid to do it. And then there's some, like David Avila, he's one of the best that knows women, you know. He knows the ins and outs. He knows everybody that's ranked. He knows everything, you know. There's some that are really passionate, and there's some that just really don't care. There's also, you know, the fact that, you know, big promotional groups are barely starting to put us on that big platform on DAZN, on ESPN, on Sky, you know. The fact that we were missing for so long on those big platforms hurt us a lot. But right now we're going forward, and I'm happy that I'm part of this era that, you know, is opening more doors for the women that are coming.
Yeah, you definitely, you know, every time you do a press conference, every time you do a weigh-in, you know, fight fans just love what you bring to the table, especially on fight night. So we look forward to seeing another action-packed fight against Marina Esparza. So wish you the best of luck on fight night, and thank you so much for taking the time.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. It's always a pleasure, and hope to talk to you guys again soon.
Definitely. We'll do it again soon. Thank you so much, Shalane. Un saludo. Que tengas buen día.
Saludo. Hasta luego.
Ándale. Gracias.